to draw manga. Every weeb since the 2000s probably got at least one of these books. As a weeaboo queen, I got 20. Alongside the rise of manga in the United States, there was an iconic series of how to draw manga tutorial books that cluttered the art section of your local Borders in 2003. Later joined by many other tutorials made domestically that made a bag full of elementary, middle, and high schoolers just ready to try their hand at drawing their animated senpais. And I was in that generation. According to this statistic I just made up, if you clicked on this video, you're within that generation. Were these books a problem for young artists, or is drawing manga a phase that just needs to be left behind like your Naruto headband? In 2000, Japanime Company Limited teamed up with Graphixia to publish How to Draw Manga, Getting Started. They followed with a series of books, but this particular series with the red logo, I consider to be the most iconic of these books. Looking at the Graphixia website and Japanime, aka Manga University, which sadly isn't a real university, which was a website that was the official online store for these books, and the other stuff they published. When I was younger, I went here a lot to learn from the tutorials. Manga University started publishing original stuff within their niche, and eventually seems like the business with Graphixia stopped. But these books was also distributed by Digital Manga Distribution and Japan Publications. But this series from Graphixia will always be THE How to Draw Manga book to me. Not because they're god tier, but because they were so everywhere. They were the poster child of the craze. Are these books even good or even the best at teaching manga? The best part about this particular one, it comes with this really hilarious story at the beginning of this beleaguered manga artist right after they just went through hell. Also lots of drinking. Lots of drinking. But other than that, Compelling Characters, also known as Volume 1, is very well-rounded. It covers a body structure, screen tones, what type of pens are usually used, and even goes through how to write a story. And look, it comes with its own TV tropes page! Also, I love this expression chart that's inside. It makes me all crying loudly, sorrow, thinking, troubled, surprised, being upset, anger, violent, anger, loud, laughter, smile, and normal, all at the same time. I think I should get that checked out. The thing is, this series of books is dated. They came out 20 years ago, and the design of characters and manga and the techniques to make manga are a bit different in the 2020s. The traditional techniques are still used, but all the books that mention anything digital is pretty, yeah. If you do use these, find some more modern examples of manga art by just browsing around Barnes & Noble and being a manga cow that just reads a stack of manga on the floor that you won't buy. Get out of the way! You're in the way of me trying to get the next, I don't know, Komi Can't Communicate! Most of these manga books fall into two categories, reference and techniques. References are just images to help you draw, and it's pretty cool because you can just pick it up and you don't have to go to Google and then get distracted and end up 4 hours later arguing on Twitter about Midwestern dessert. My religion is Pocky and Haichu, not Jell-O salad, Brenda! May or may not be based on a true story. There's whole books in Japan for just reference that shows poses from every angle. I found some images online and I was drooling. I need these type of books so bad. Technique is just what it says on the tin. It teaches you how to do the skills and the tools for the skills. I've been collecting these type of books for years. Even though manga style isn't the bread and butter of my art anymore, I still take lots of inspiration from manga and anime, and I still learn from these books even though I branched out to more toonie styles and other influences. Before I even touched my first book, I tried to draw what I saw in anime like Sailor Moon and Pokemon. I got the spark to create from it! I didn't have a computer to learn from people online, so these books were the only way I could learn how to draw for my future 3-volume trilogy epic fantasy manga I wanted to do when I was 15. But okay, I did get okay enough to impress all the weirdos at my lunch table at school. We were the weird table. We played Yu-Gi-Oh! A lot of young artists in the last 20 years had a run-in with these how to draw manga books, even here on YouTube.
Well, when I was a kid, everyone in my family knew that I loved drawing, so I was always gifted art sets or supplies, so I had a fat stack of how to draw books, and then my mom always bought them for me too. And then I think you can just visually tell the difference in quality for how to draw books that were created by people who actually loved the manga slash anime style compared to books that were clearly trying to emulate it but less successfully. I have lots of books that look like they were made by an artist who hasn't ever drawn in that style before.
The Graphic Shaw series sold pretty well, and with the concurrent anime boom of the 2000s just inspiring more people, other publishers saw dollar 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 signs! Here's an edu advertisement for Deleter called Manga Techniques Volume 1 Drawing Manga for Beginners. Deleter is a company that makes and sells manga making materials. They're well known for their screen tones. Those are like the sticky patterns you stick on a page when you work traditionally that result in those dots, clouds, gradients, and more. And they sell pens, paper, and all sorts of tools you need for manga. Hashtag not sponsored, but give me some yen. And yeah, we can make that happen. So it kind of makes sense to build on that by making a how-to series. Since screen tones is their thing, half of this book is about how to use them. And even as a digital clip studio hoe, learning how to use screen tones effectively is necessary if you're doing manga. Let's put this in the technique pile. Another series Graphic Shaw published is How to Draw Anime and Game Characters. I was a fan of the first volume as a teen, but I only have this one on me. And no one was making anime or games in the teen section at my library, so I used this for manga reference. This focuses on emotions and expressions. And while the styles are dated and some of the expressions you don't see in anime much, it's a good reference book for expressions. But one of my faves brought from Japan is Shoujo Beats Manga Artists Academy. It takes the using manga to teach manga approach, similar to the comic that teaches comics like Scott McCloud's Making Comics or Understanding Comics. It follows a cute panda that wants to be a shoujo manga artist and the editor that introduces her to professionals like Yu Watase or Shoko Akira. It gives a lot of space for teaching shoujo storytelling and encourages stealing techniques like, here, I love Miyuki Kitagawa's way of using screen tones for panel borders, and Yukako Isaka's traditional technique changed how I would ink effects back in the day. And this is just really fun to read, and it's firmly in the technique pile. Man, I wonder if everyone learned from these books.
And to be fully honest, I don't have any experience.
Nani?
I definitely have heard of them, and, you know, I've seen them, of course, but have I personally used them and try to use those as a way to teach myself how to draw? Definitely not. Nothing bad about them, of course, but I think everyone learns differently. But if you're talking about the books that kind of give tutorials and, you know, tips and tricks about how to draw, like, a face shape, you know, anime eyes, or I should say, manga eyes, you know, things like that, I really don't have any experience. That's just for me, though, to be fully honest with you.
In Bakuman, a manga that is about two young men that want to draw for Shonen Jump, the uncle was quoted as saying the best reference for making manga is manga. Even when I wasn't drawing manga, but just regular comics, I'd look at manga for inspirations for compositions, effect ideas, or how to portray certain panel rhythms to go with the mood. You know, rhythm as in the principle of design that creates movement. Learning from manga itself is great and valid, just like learning from how-to books. But then suddenly, America! The manga Yankees wanted a piece of that how-to-draw money pie, so they called in their best warrior to take it on.